Journalism is a challenging but also an adventurous career. You get to meet different cultures, lives, and even experiences. You get the chance to see the sides of the world and sides of people's stories. This is my job, interviewing people, writing issues, and making ways to make the nation see them. I am a graduate of a well-known university, had been to different journalism activities here and abroad, and I am a multi-awarded writer. I am currently working in a newspaper company, and this is my life. To wake up early, receive a call from my editor, cover news, go to my office, and write an article. In my 5 years in this company, I must say that this is the oddest thing I saw. It was one day when I was scrolling our official Gmail account looking for newsworthy articles.
What message?
Never.
Seems like an odd thing. Can you find and get an interview with whoever sent this message?
Yes, ma'am. I'll try.
I hope you can contact the person immediately.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes? May I know who's calling me?
Ma'am, I'm a writer from the Philippine Star and I just read the message you sent me on Gmail. Well, it's something unusual and our editor and chief would like me to get your side. So we could justify you to put that ad.
Oh, you're a writer? Well, actually, my boss made me do that. Can I just call you back when I've arranged the meeting for you?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I will try my best to interview him at his most convenient time.
Why not? I believe you've been with my friend for about 19 years. We never planned to have a baby. After all, it's impossible. I'm 38 years old, and my wife, boyfriend, husband, whatever you call him, is like 40 years old. If we don't do it now, we'll be too old to take care of the children. We have been blessed with opportunities, and we would like to share them with someone special.
So, why have you been living with a man all these years?
I love him.
How did that happen? You don't look gay at all.
You see, I met a friend when I was 20 years old. He was 2 years older than I. And that, although there were birth control pills, they were not easy available to women. My parents always warned and threatened me that if I ever get a woman pregnant before I finish college, they will stop supporting me as a college.
What about your plans for having a baby? Is this with your friend's consent?
Yes, we talked about it for a million times, I think. We have decided not to ask any of our female friends because we don't want any complications later.
She might get emotionally attached to the child when we might end up in court. Will be less complicated if the woman will be willing to do it for financial reasons, and it's just like proposal and everything will be done legally. I will sign the birth certificate as a father, but the woman will have to waive all her rights to the child.
And how do you plan to make the baby?
Well, the normal way of people make babies, except that there will be 3 rooms. We plan to have everything monitored by a doctor friend of ours who works at the most exclusive hospitals here. I guess one can say that this is sad, but I guess there's always a first time for everything. I will produce the child myself by going through the whole sexual process with the hired surrogate mother.
Ha ha! Then what will your friend be? The surrogate mother?
No, I'll be called Papa and my friend will be called Tito or Papa Juan. But you know that Juan is not his real name.
What about the morals here, the Catholic Church, maybe?
Well, yes, well, we have considered that too. The Catholic Church is a strange institution. We're doing this to reproduce. Isn't it the Bible says? Go forth and multiply? If they will not baptize our child, there are other religions we can join.
Do you feel sorry for the mother of the child?
Yes, ma'am. I do anticipate some problems. But if a woman is in financial need, I hate to say this, I believe that everything will be a lot easier. She'll agree due to the financial reasons. The whole purpose of having a contract signed by a woman myself is to protect the child.
The child might be used as a pawn to make us more money. We will be sparing the mother pain and agony. We have read so many magazines and injured our female friends about child rearing. Please also bear in that mind that I will be the biological father. So I see nothing wrong with hiring a surrogate mother.
Well, I got my answer and I will relay this to our editor-in-chief. Thank you for your time and nice to see you again.
Sure.
For my boss, and I've heard your conversation, and I've discovered that you've been friends for a very long time. So, can you please help me become close to him?
I have known Dimbu since we were in high school, and we even went to the same university. But you know, I left for the United States, and when I came back, I just found out about the Gmail and everything, and then, well, we've been living together for 19 years now. That's a very long time, right? So I don't think I can help you with that.
Okay, I see. But can you please just help me become the surrogate mother for them? Please convince them, please.
Well, sure. I'll try to do my best to see what I can do. Can I go now?
But Kuya borrowed 300,000 and it's not enough. I didn't qualify the cost of the deal.
So what are we going to do?
I don't know.
What? No, guys, it's not happening. Don't worry, it's going to be alright. We're going to find a job. It's going to be alright.
Yes, come in. I just came here to submit some articles, and I actually got the interview from the sender of the ad message. Well, his reasons seem reasonable enough.
Is that so? Then publish it in our ad section for tomorrow's issue then.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, who's this?
Hello. Hey, it's me.
Well, yes, the editor-in-chief already approved. You should thank me for that.
Is that so? I told my friend about what we talk about, and we're asking you to come to dinner. Is that okay?
Okay, I have a deadline tomorrow, but you can pick me up at 7 p.m. tonight.
We'll pick you up then. See you.
Okay, thank you. Goodbye.
How was America?
It was good.
I haven't seen you for so long.
Well, I know for sure that after we graduated in high school and I hurting me is because just after my parents separated, my father got me there. So I majored in journalism and I worked in a local TV station there before moving here to the Philippines. And I again worked with mass media, but since I want to try other avenues, I went to the Philippine Star, applied there, and luckily I'm working there under Mr. Cab for 5 years now.
Excuse me for a while, but I'm going to go to the CR, right? You know, I go first, yes?
Yes, yeah.
So, what about you two? How did your relationship start?
How old are you?
20.
You good?
Yep.
Are you sure you're not sick or something?
Of course not. I'm very happy.
Well then, let's go.
Oh, you're gay then.
Well, I slept with women with pleasure, but I don't fall in love with them. I'm a straight guy, but I have fallen in love with my friend. Am I gay?
No, you're not, but you're sick.
No, I'm perfect. Normal bisexual.
Say what?
My desire of women and my friend, only my friend, but not other gay men, are equal.
Thank you for dinner.
Sure, my pleasure.
But
she,
her IQ is so low. Oh,
wow.
I don't like that.
No.
Next!
Sa tingin mo, bakit ka qualified dito sa work?
Well, sir, I think I'm qualified because I was raised by my parents with good manners, sir. And I'm still a virgin, sir.
Oh.
Yes.
I don't like her. Because she's too provincial. You see? Her outfit. Oh my gosh.
Why so judgmental, sir?
Next.
Well, good morning, ma'am. Please take a seat. Let me see your reference. Why do you think you're appropriate for this job?
Because my family, they're not eating. 3 times a day, they're not eating. Can't you see? My burned skin? I need money.
Oh, I see. What do you think?
No, still no.
Why?
Because she's more handsome than you.
Oh my gosh. Oh boy.
Come on, do you want our child to be more handsome than you? No.
What?
Of course. Next.
Aren't you my secretary?
Yes, sir.
What? Well, say. Have a seat.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
You let your secretary apply for the job?
I think she needs a job.
You know? I'll just ask her the question.
Okay, why do you think you're appropriate for this job?
Well, because I think it's the right time to tell you that I love you and that I'm willing to take it.
Oh, I see. Darling?
The reason is grand. What did you just say?
I love him.
You love my husband.
Well,
wait.
Next. Why do you think you're appropriate for this job?
Because I have the ability, sir. Apart from that, I'm a cum laude.
Oh, a cum laude, darling. What do you think?
Well, wait. Let's see your abilities. Oh my gosh.
What?
She's good at karate, taekwondo. No.
Next.
You don't like. Ma'am.
Good evening, sir.
Let me see your resume. Please. Oh, I see. Pretty good. Miss, I'll ask you one question. Why are you encouraged to go here, and is this you think is appropriate for your applying for a job?
It's just simple, sir. My father is in the parade
the money right ahead. Please spare me, just give me the job, and I will promise you I will not need it. I promise you.
Well, darling, she needs money. What do you think?
Well, I like her.
Yeah,
she's good, the good intelligence, yeah. She's right, not too high, not too low. She's good. I love her abilities, she's good. You're good at cooking, right?
Yeah, she's pretty.
And she doesn't look like a provinciana, but she doesn't not look like not from the cities. Just good.
Yeah, just like...
Oh my gosh, please smile for a little. Yeah, just smile. Oh my, can you see those?
Come on, what?
I like those things.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Check her.
See you, honey.
Yeah,
can you
wow.
see our baby? Oh, smile, darling. Oh,
yes,
there.
A beautiful. Yes.
Yeah.
It's very beautiful and very
come on, just
affectionate. So,
I love it.
I think we have a... customer, I think?
No, she will be a partner. Just
no, customer slash partner.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
You're hard. Be happy.
Thank you,
don't worry for the money.
Thank you, sir.
One.